Welcome to the Philippine Motor Show. This is Auto Focus. I'm Ray Louis Gamboa. Here's a menu of some of our features on this edition of your electronic magazine, exclusive to the automobile and its industry.
Starting off with reviews of two vehicle models presently in the local market, a mini MPV from Honda, the Mobilio 1.5V CVT, and a compact sedan from Volkswagen, the 2019 LaMondo Comfortline. Plus, a feature-to-feature comparison of two subcompact sedans, the 2020 Hyundai Reina 1.4 GL 4-speed automatic and the 2019 Kia Soluto 1.4 EX automatic. And together, with the latest news and developments in the local auto industry, we shall have the launch of the Ford F-150 as our special feature.
The next 60 minutes is all about the automobile. This is Auto Focus, and we'll be right back after this short break.
Be part of the 2020-2021 Autofocus People's Choice Awards, the only nationwide poll to determine the country's most popular car brands and models. It's easy. Log on, then vote for as many as 5 different models that you believe should become the 2020-2021 Autofocus Automobile of the Year in separate standard and premium luxury categories. Vote every day until September 30, 2020. The Autofocus People's Choice Awards. Who will win? You choose, you decide. Vote now.
The Mitsubishi Mirage.
Welcome back to Auto Focus, the automobile show. We start this edition of your electronic magazine with a review of one of the latest automobile models from Honda. Seven-seater automobiles for the family now come in various shapes and sizes. There are MUVs or multi-utility vehicles, SUVs or sport utility vehicles, and MPVs or multi-purpose vehicles. Well, MPVs are, in essence, just bigger MUVs, depending on where you are in the world. A seven-seater can be called a compact MUV or a mini MPV, like the Honda Mobilio.
Honda Cars Philippines has a number of 7-seater vehicles in its lineup. 7-seaters are sought by families who like their versatility for carrying passengers and cargo, and can either come in the form of SUVs or sports utility vehicles, MUVs or multi-utility vehicles, or MPVs or multi-purpose vehicles, depending on desired lifestyles and budgets. The most affordable 7-seater in Honda's local lineup is the Mobilio, positioned as a compact MUV or mini MPV if you like. Although its most expensive variant tops the SRP of the least expensive BRV, another of Honda's 7-seaters, but positioned as a compact SUV. In this edition of Car Review, we'll take a look at the Honda Mobilio 1.5V CVT. The Mobilio cuts a sleek figure on the road at 4,386mm long, 1,683mm wide, and 1,603mm tall. It clears the ground by 189mm, and has a 2,652 millimeter wheelbase. The latest edition Mobilio got a recent facelift that many said gave it an edgier look, although the description may be more literal than figurative. But you know it's a Honda from design cues as well as quality of fit and finish. Design cues aside, the Mobilio 1.5V CVT exterior comes with multi-reflector halogen headlights, fog lights on the front Fox air ducts, turn lights integrated into the side view mirrors, body color door handles, micro type antenna, bulb type tail lamp, high mount LED stop lamp. It also has intermittent front wipers with washer and standard rear wipers with washer. The Mobilio rides on a 185x65 R15 tires, wrapped around 15x5.5 aluminum alloy wheels. The cabin has seats for 7, the dark cloth upholstery complementing the dark hues of plastic dash and trim. Headroom, elbow and leg room for front seats and second row seat can be best described as perfectly adequate for an MUV. Third row seats can be tight for adults. The 60/40 second row seating slides, reclines, folds, and tumbles. The 50/50 third row seating split folds and tumbles. The folding and tumbling increase cargo capacity from 223 liters to 470 liters, with all seats upright to 521 liters. The Mobilio dash and instrumentation embodies the U in MUV, with Honda favoring a no-frills, elegant yet sporty approach to design. Comfort and convenience features enhance utility in the cabin, starting with a smart entry, power door locks and windows, 4 bottle holders, 5 cup holders, pockets to hold stuff on front and rear doors, front and rear dome lights, grab rails for 4 to aid ingress and egress, an accessory 12-volt socket. The air conditioning system has manual controls with digital display on the dash, plus aircon controls for rear passengers. The infotainment system uses a 7-inch touchscreen with Bluetooth and USB connectivity, and plays through 4 speakers. The driver enjoys electronic power steering using a 3-spoke urethane with silver trim steering wheel that adjusts for tilt. Powering the Mobilio is a 1,497cc single overhead cam iVTEC inline 4 16-valve engine that generates a maximum 120 PS at 6,600 revolutions per minute and 145 Nm of torque at 4,600 RPM with drive-by-wire accelerator pedal control. The power is transmitted to the front wheels via Honda's Earth Dreams technology continuously variable transmission. The brake system uses front ventilated discs and rear drums. The suspension system features front McPherson struts with coil spring and stabilizer, and torsion beam axle and coil spring in the rear. The Mobilio 1.5V CVT does not lack for passive and safety features, now expected as standard in all cars. It comes with anti-lock braking system and electronic brake force distribution. The keyless entry system is complemented by alarm and immobilizer. All 7 passengers get 3-point ELR seatbelts with wear seatbelt reminders for driver and front seat passenger. The Mobilio also has ISOFIX child seat anchors and child safety door locks.
The Honda Mobilio certainly deserves more than a look-see for those in the lookout for an affordable and versatile 7-seat cargo and people mover. The latest auto industry news and developments right after this break.
Elevate your journey. The new Montero Sport.
Drive your ambition. Mitsubishi Motors.
What do we go for? We go for experience. We go for excitement. We go for sport. We go for style. We go for fun. We go for the new Toyota Wego.
Welcome back to Auto Focus. And we now have the latest auto industry news.
Kia Philippines isn't phased by the new normal of tomorrow. Kia owners should feel confident that a dealership will always be there to serve their needs well into the new normal.
Major concern would always be the customer. So we thought, what would be critical for our customers to be safe? Because that was a major block for them to come and visit. So during the full lockdown, we went into a lot of preparation so that once the lockdown eases, customers would have the peace of mind to come and visit us. So we worked on that together with our dealers. We provided them several guidelines on how to make that whole dealership, whether they are into the sales area or in the after sales area, everything would be so sanitized and for peace of mind.
Kia is steadfast in pushing through with its plans to open 4 new dealerships by the third quarter of the year. These are Kia Marikina, Kia Fairview, Kia Isabela, and Kia Bonifacio Global City. This should bring the number of Kia sales and service facilities to 34. It adds that 4 more facilities are planned for opening by the end of 2020 and in 2021.
We want to ensure our buying public that the vehicles that they would like to carry from us are available at better pricing. So that's a number one in our plan. July, for example, very hefty promo discounts, financing packages, because we want to participate in the normalization of the overall environment. We also worked on the after sales because we know equally important as purchasing a car is owning and maintaining the vehicle. So we have worked on the after sales element of the business, especially with our dealers, so that once you own it, maintaining it is not going to be a problem.
And Kia promises to launch more new models to add to its already comprehensive lineup of vehicles, catering various needs, lifestyle choices, and budgets of Filipino buyers.
Towards the end of this year, we will also do another unboxing, a new model that we will be introducing to the market. Again, in addition to what we have already offered as our participation for the recovering economy of the country, we would like to bring in another one that will help our riding public. We will unbox that fourth quarter this year.
Mitsubishi Motors Philippines wants to add the success of its best-selling crossover MPV with the launch of the Expander Cross, which it describes as a family-friendly 7-seater crossover MPV built with solid SUV styling, comfortable and present drivability, as well as a spacious, practical, and versatile interior design. First launched in 2018, the Expander got a warm response in the local market, with Mitsubishi reporting sales of 36,168 units, which amounts to 30% of the company's total vehicle sales. The Expander is a very important product to MMPC as it fits many of the vehicle requirements of Filipinos. It provides the reliable performance, spacious and comfortable interior, host of safety features, and a very bold design. Now with the entry of the Expander Cross and its added features, we see renewed potential to the already successful Expander nameplate, said MMPC President and CEO Oshikiri. What differentiates the Expander Cross from its brethren? A new front grille and bumper design, LED headlights and fog lamps, 17-inch two-tone alloy wheels, new fender arc and side body molding, new rear garnish, and LED combination lamp, roof rails. Mitsubishi boasts of class-leading 225 millimeters of ground clearance for the Xpander Cross for traversing more challenging terrains without compromising ride comfort. You can get the Xpander Cross for 1,255,000 pesos. Isuzu Philippines Corporation has turned over initial proceeds of its Isuzu Kasama Mo campaign, launched last June 1, 2020, to partner with institutions engaged in providing assistance to medical and other frontliners in the fight against the COVID-19 pandemic.
Today, we are officially turning over the first batch of medical PPEs to our partner organization as part of our Isuzu Kasama Mo campaign.
The campaign aims to donate corresponding amounts of medical personal protection equipment, or PPE, for every Isuzu vehicle sold from June 1 to July 31, 2020. The initial number of donated PPEs were turned over in simple rites at the IPC head office in Binyan, Laguna, to representatives of the Philippine Coast Guard, the Philippine Red Cross, and Caritas Manila.
To all the televiewers and Isuzu clients out there, visit any of our Isuzu dealership in Nationwide and inquire about our latest product and promotion. We assure you of our strict health and safety protocol and sanitation process. For those who wish to inquire at the convenience of their home, check out our new digital dealer page and talk to us online. Log on to www.isuzufil.com for more details. Thank you very much.
All British Cars, exclusive distributor of Jaguar cars in the country, has brought the all-electric Jaguar I-Pace to its new BGC boutique showroom. Jaguar touts the I-Pace as its smartest five-seater sports car. A 90-kilowatt lithium-ion high-voltage battery powers two electric motors mounted at the axles that combined generate 400 horsepower and 696 newton-meters of torque. The motors send power to all four wheels. Jaguar claims the I-Pace can go from 0 to 100 kilometers per hour in 4.8 seconds. The I-Pace comes with a 7-kilowatt Type 2 plug, 7-kilowatt wall charger. Charging from zero to full takes about 12 hours. A single full charge provides a range of up to 570 kilometers. It also features the new PV Pro infotainment system. All British Cars is now accepting orders for the all-electric Jaguar I-Pace, which comes at 7,590,000 pesos. Clients may also purchase an additional charger for second homes or offices at the cost of 105,000 pesos. It comes with an 8-year, 160,000-kilometer warranty. All British Cars, exclusive distributor of Land Rover vehicles in the Philippines, has brought in two variants of the Range Rover, powered by plug-in hybrid electric engines, the Range Rover PHEV and the Range Rover Sport PHEV. The new Range Rover variants joined Land Rover's local lineup of hybrid models. The first, the Range Rover Evoque, a mild hybrid electric vehicle, was launched last year. Both Range Rover PHEV and Range Rover Sport PHEV are powered by a 2-liter Ingenium turbocharged petrol engine, complemented by an 85-kilowatt electric motor. Combined, the petrol engine and electric motor generates 404 horsepower and 640 newton-meters of torque. Both come with a 13 kWh high-voltage lithium-ion battery that can be charged from zero to full in 2 hours and 45 minutes. The PHEV powertrain provides two modes of driving. The parallel hybrid mode combines petrol and electric drive, giving the Range Rover a range of 700 kilometers. The electric vehicle mode only uses the electric motor for a quieter and emission-free drive, but with a range of only 50 kilometers on a single charge. Both come with a Type 2 plug 7 kWh wall charger.
Those are the latest news and developments in the automotive industry. We shall take another short break. Stay with us. I'll be right back.
What do we go for? We go for experience. We go for excitement. We go for sport. We go for style. We go for fun. We go for the new Toyota Wego.
Be part of the 2020-2021 Autofocus People's Choice Awards, the only nationwide poll to determine the country's most popular car brands and models. It's easy. Log on, then vote for as many as 5 different models that you believe should become the 2020-2021 Autofocus Automobile of the Year in separate standard and premium luxury categories. Vote every day until September 30, 2020. The Autofocus People's Choice Awards. Who will win? You choose, you decide. Vote now.
Welcome back to this edition of Autofocus, the country's premier automobile TV and online magazine. Here's our feature-to-feature comparison of the latest automobile models belonging to the same category on head-to-head. Many are expecting the sales of budget subcompact sedans to surge as the economy restarts after being shut down for more than 3 months because of the COVID-19 pandemic. Korean car makers and distributors are poised to take advantage with completely priced entry-level subcompact sedans. Head-to-head pits two Korean entry-level sedans in this category, the Kia Soluto and the Hyundai Rain, in a spec-to-spec comparison.
It's complicated. The relationship between South Korean automakers Hyundai and Kia. Both own substantial shares in each other's companies, but compete in virtually all auto market segments in the same regions and countries. While employing separate sets of engineers, designers, and marketing people, and partnering with different distributors in the same countries or regions, they sometimes share the same platform for respective models competing in the same various segments. Like the Hyundai Reina and the Kia Soluto, entry-level subcompact sedans competing in a crowded market made even more competitive by the COVID-19 pandemic. Hyundai's official website lists 4 Reinas available for sale. Reina 1.4GL 5-speed manual transmission. Reina 1.4GL 4-speed automatic transmission. Reina 1.4GL 5-speed manual transmission with AVN. Reina 1.4GL 4-speed automatic transmission with AVN. Kia also lists 4 variants of the Soluto on its website. Soluto 1.4LX manual transmission, Soluto 1.4LX automatic transmission, Soluto 1.4EX manual transmission, Soluto 1.4EX automatic transmission. Sharing the same platform, the Reina and Soluto have virtually the same dimensions. The Hyundai, only wider by 5 millimeters. The Reina is 4,300 millimeters long, 1,705 millimeters wide, and 1,460 millimeters at its highest point. The Soluto is as long and tall, but just 1,700 millimeters wide. It's no surprise that they share the same 2,570 millimeter wheelbase. They also have similar suspension systems. The Reina comes with McPherson struts with stabilizer in front and coupled torsion beam axle in the rear. Kia describes the Saluto suspension as front McPherson strut with H-type subframe and rear V-beam coupled torsion beam axle. Both the Riina and Saluto, being sold in the country, have 1.4-liter engines underneath their hoods. The Riina is powered by a 1,368cc MPI or multi-point injector gasoline engine that generates a maximum 95 horsepower at 6,000 revolutions per minute and 132 newton meters of torque at 4,000 RPM. In the Riina variant we have, the power is sent to the front wheels via a 4-speed automatic transmission. The Kia Saluto is powered by a 1,368cc inline-4 gasoline engine with dual CVVT that similarly generates 95 PS at 6,000 RPM and 132 Nm of torque at 4,000 RPM. The engine is mated to a 4-speed automatic transmission. Both Riina and Saluto also used front discs and rear drums for braking. A large hexagonal grille dominates the Riina's fascia, making it, along with fluidic lines of its exterior, unmistakably a Hyundai. Other exterior features include halogen headlamps and body-colored side view mirrors, side turn signals on fenders. The Saluto 1.4EX exterior features front fog lamps, turn signal indicators on side mirrors, and chrome outside door handles. It also comes with 14-inch alloy wheels wrapped by 170x70 R14 size tires. Both the Riina and Saluto can sit five comfortably with interior amenities that come standard in most entry-level sedans. The Riina boasts, among other things, fixed rear headrests, central door locks, power front windows, room lamps, air conditioning with manual controls, sun visors for driver and front seat passenger. The motor-driven power steering features a tiltable steering wheel, LCD display for info, such as average fuel consumption, complements a conventional instrument cluster. Entertainment comes from a 1-DIN AM/FM radio unit with USB connections for standard Riina variants. The Kia Saluto sports leatherette upholstery. The driver's seat has an armrest, and like the front passenger seat, reclines and slides. It also adds height adjust for driver. The 3-spoke steering wheel with audio and hands-free phone controls and shift knob get the leather treatment. The instrument panel features analog speedometer and tachometer and a digital fuel gauge, trip meter, temperature gauge. Other amenities and convenience features include smart keyless entry, power windows and door locks, air conditioning with manual control, console box with power outlet and 2-cup holders, bottle holders on all doors, day-night rear view mirrors, chrome dashboard trim, and silver inside door handles. Its infotainment system includes a 7-inch touchscreen, AM/FM radio, MP3 with USB, and aux in ports, Bluetooth connectivity with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto with voice control, and 4 speakers with 2 tweeters. The Saluto also boasts rear camera display, with EX variants getting added rear parking sensors. Safety features in all 2020 Hyundai Riinas include dual airbags, seatbelts for 5, an anti-lock brake system. In the Saluto, safety features include ABS, airbags for driver and front seat passenger, 3-point seat belts for 4 with load limiters for those in front, 2-point seat belt for middle passenger in the car, child seat anchor, and child locks for rear doors. The EX also gets a immobilizer.
After comparing specs of the many budget-friendly entry-level subcompact sedans, would-be buyers should also check out the promos and auto companies and dealers are out throwing out there. It's really an interesting time for the auto industry in what it is turning out to be a buyer's market.
fine dining, a romantic garden wedding, a relaxed casual meal, or an important business event, Ilustrado is the place to go. Aside from its famed paella, the Ilustrado restaurant, which is located within the history-laden walled city of Intramuros, is also the favorite destination of food gourmands for its famous callos and lengua and other classic gustatory offerings. Ilustrado Restaurant, only for the foodies.
Welcome back to Autofocus, the country's premier automobile news and features electronic magazine. Our special feature is next. The F-150 has returned to join Ford's local lineup of Ford-built tough pickups and SUVs. The COVID-19 pandemic threw a spanner into Ford Philippines' plan to reintroduce the U.S.'s best pickup back to the country last March. But there's no stopping Ford. The F-150 was launched online last June 24. Autofocus visited Ford via an exclusive Zoom session to dig deeper into the decision to bring back the F-150.
Would you believe that every 53 seconds, a new Ford F-150 is built in the US of A? This is one bit of trivia learned during the digital reveal of the Ford F-150. Whether this remains true as the entire world grapples with the effects of COVID-19 on the economy and communities everywhere, it is still an astounding fact. No less astounding is that Ford Philippines remains steadfast in bringing back the F-150 and confident there's a market for America's best-selling vehicle 38 years running. This is learned when Autofocus got an exclusive Zoom session with Ford Philippines Marketing Director Ryan Lorenzo, presenting a quick preview of the two variants, the F-150 4x4 Platinum Super Crew Automatic and the F-150 4x2 Lariat Super Crew Automatic.
Hi, good afternoon, guys. So thank you for joining us this afternoon. So here, actually, right beside me, we have our two F-150 variants. So maybe before we start the discussion, maybe I'll take you through it very quickly. So to my left here, you will see we have the 4x4 Platinum F-150 that we have. And then to my right is actually the 4x2 Lariat that we are offering. You will see up front for the Platinum, you will see that we have this satin chrome finish up front. So it's a little bit more stylish and luxurious, I would say, compared to the Lariat, who is very sporty. And then you will see 20-inch satin chrome wheels with all-terrain tires for the Platinum. And then you'll notice it once I open it, this actually shares the power deployable running boards that we have for the Expedition. And then you would have all of the convenience features inside. So power seats, the steering wheel actually adjusts. So with the pedals, okay, so those are all power adjustable. You have leather seats here. And then one good thing for the Platinum, it comes with a dual panel moonroof already. And then the sound system for this one, we have a 10-speaker Bang & Olufsen. The standard for this vehicle. I move towards the 4x2 Lariat, guys. You will see that up front, it's actually color-coded. And then you have more black accents all around the vehicle because this Lariat actually comes standard already with the sport appearance package. It's an option for other countries, but for us, it's already standard. So we took that option and it comes with these darker 20-inch wheels, okay? So actually this complements the whole look of this 4x2, which I would say is a little bit sportier compared to the 4x4 Platinum that we have. both come with a 3.5 liter EcoBoost engine that is mated to a 10-speed automatic transmission. It also comes with start-stop technology. So actually that will really help, aside from the aluminum body, with the fuel consumption and fuel economy for the vehicle.
It's been around 2 decades since Ford Philippines had the F-150 in its lineup of pickups being sold in the country. Why bring it back now?
What gave us confidence, I'll already go into that, in bringing this F-150 back. Okay, I would say the performance of the Ranger trucks that we have here, I would say especially for the Raptor, okay? Because I would say we're very happy with the Raptor performance. On certain months, it actually accounts to close to 50% of our sales. So with that, it kind of gave us some confidence that the Filipino consumer, aside from the increasing segment size for pickups, it's around 16-17% right now, aside from that, that the market is ready for something maybe a step further from the Raptor, something with more refinement and actually more power.
Despite the huge price difference between the Ford Ranger Raptor and the F-150 variants now on sale at Ford dealerships, doesn't Ford Philippines fear the Raptor and the F-150 will eat into each other's markets?
It's hard to deny that there is going to be some overlap with the two vehicles, okay? But for the F-150 Raptor, we are looking at someone who is, of course, accomplished, and then who is looking for more of a lifestyle vehicle versus the Ranger. And this one, I would say, would be the ultimate truck if you want something really up there in the market.
There's a lot to the F-150 that sets it apart from the competition. Among other things, the F-150 features Ford Co-Pilot 360, Ford Safety Suite, composed of pre-collision assist with autonomous emergency braking, adaptive cruise control, blind spot information system, lane keeping system, and auto high beam headlamps. It is equipped with a remote start system, remote tailgate release, 8-inch LCD touchscreen, Sync 3 with Apple Link, Apple CarPlay, and Android Auto compatibility, 2 smart charging USB ports, and 12-volt PowerPoint, navigation system, 8-inch productivity screen in the instrument cluster. It is also packed with driver assist technologies, which include 360-degree camera with split-view display, active park assist, curve control, Hill Start Assist, SOS Post-Crash Alert System, Trailer Sway Control, Rain Sensing Wipers, and Reverse Sensing System. Then, there are the Advanced Track with Roll Stability Control, Dual Stage Front Airbags, Front Seat Side Airbags, and Safety Canopy System with Side Curtain Airbags and Rollover Sensor, Individual Tire Pressure Monitoring System, Security Lock Passive Anti-Theft System, Anti-Lock Braking System, and Electronic Brake Force Distribution. And Perimeter Alarm, the Platinum variant, even has inflatable rear seat belts. Still, what is the main selling point of the F-150?
The F-150 brand is very strong in America, and slowly we are bringing it to the export markets again for Philippines. We've sold this before, back in 1998, and it's back right now for us. So given that strong F-150 brand really gives us that, I would say, confidence that we can sell this again here in the Philippines.
We'll be right back.
everybody is in the same boat with the COVID-19 pandemic. Marketing efforts are being shifted to digital and online platforms. But showrooms are now open under strict health protocols to protect both team members and customers against infection. And like others in the auto industry, Ford also accepts appointments for viewing and test driving cars. So, what are you waiting for?
What do we go for? We go for experience. We go for excitement. We go for sport. We go for style. We go for fun. We go for the new Toyota Wego.
Be part of the 2020-2021 Autofocus People's Choice Awards, the only nationwide poll to determine the country's most popular car brands and models. It's easy. Log on, then vote for as many as 5 different models that you believe should become the 2020-2021 Autofocus Automobile of the Year in separate standard and premium luxury categories. Vote every day until September 30, 2020. The Autofocus People's Choice Awards. Who will win? You choose, you decide. Vote now.
Strada Athlete. Unleash the athlete.
Motul is the most trusted motor oil of the top teams competing in some of the world's most grueling race competitions. The WRC, the WTCC, and the Japan GT. Motul is the only 100% fully synthetic motor oil in the market. It has antioxidation properties that prevent premature thickening and aging due to thermal stress and guarantees total engine protection. For more information about Motul engine oils, visit www.motul.com.ph.
Welcome back. We have more cars for you to know and appreciate as we have our second car review this week. Shortly after its debut in the Philippines, the Volkswagen Lamando comes in with additional features and details. What's new with the well-loved sedan? Find out here. Watch this.
First things first, the exterior. The design and styling of the Lamando is one that looks familiar while also offering something different. The strong character lines that hug the body of the compact sedan, as well as the black sunroof, give off a powerful stance. The car powers through the roads with 17-inch alloy wheels. Let's check out the interior of the Lamando. Inside, the Lamando offers generous legroom, headroom, and cabin space. Both drivers and rear seats are comfortable thanks to the leather material. Speaking of seats, the driver's seat comes in electric 8-way adjustable, while the front passenger seat comes in 4-way manual. For added comfort convenience, the LaMando is equipped with a 2-zone climatronic air conditioning, power steering, power door locks, and power windows. When it comes to the infotainment system, the LaMando comes with the active info display, which features a 9.2-inch infotainment audio system with 8 speakers, available in CD, MP3, AUX, Bluetooth, USB, Apple CarPlay, and Android Auto connectivity. It's time to check out what's under the hood of the LaMando. Powering the LaMando is a 1.4-liter, 4-cylinder, inline turbo-fuel-injected gasoline engine with Blue Motion technology. On top of that, the turbocharged stratified injection, or TSI, mated with the 7-speed direct shift gear transmission, combines the convenience of an automatic and the fuel efficiency of a manual. It gives out 150 horsepower and maximum torque of 250 newton meters. When it comes to safety and security, the LaMando is equipped with a roster of features that ensure nothing less. It includes anti-lock braking system with electronic brake force distribution, stability control, parking sensors, hill start assist, tire pressure monitor, ISOFIX, and 6 airbags.
That was all about the 2019 Volkswagen LaMando Comfort Line. Its tough yet friendly features make it a sought-after sedan. Know more about your car and how to take care of it here on Autopedia.
Hi, this is Sydney, and today we will be talking about fuel-saving devices. Whether they work, or do they not? For as long as there have been gasoline engines and fuel that goes into our cars, there will always be people who will try to sell you fuel-saving devices. Now, the hallmark of these things are like the pyramid scheme. More power, better efficiency, better mileage. Sometimes they attach a number to it, up to 30%. And if they're really great, up to 50%. Then this is the latest in the long line of them. This is the killer power box. This has been making the rounds of the various car clubs, and as with every fuel saving device, the claims are always like this. More power, very satisfied customer feedback. Less usok. Okay, let's put it in the test, shall we? As with any claims of better power test, we always put the car on the dyno because very simple. The machine doesn't lie. It cannot lie even if we wanted it to. We've actually seen a number of these things over the years that we've been doing. DOST and DOE actually certify us to do the benchmark testing for anybody who wants to market these things and wants to get a certification from them. So we're going to put this killer power box, install it on the engine, put it on the dyno and see that if it really does make power. And let's set the bar kind of low. We're happy with 10 horses. Doesn't need to be 30 horses, doesn't need to be 50. 10 horses will do fine. Absolutely no gain. Voila. Zero gain. Absolutely none. We'll do it one more time, just to make sure, and nobody can say anything. absolutely no gain whatsoever. If you want to think about it, it's actually a slight power drop of about 4 horses. You will run into these kinds of devices on your Facebook feed, on your car groups, on your friends who will tell you that there's this latest power saving device. It's very simple. If they promise horsepower in double digit gains, fuel economy savings in also double digit gains, it is not true. Don't even bother thinking twice. And then it is too cheap and too good to be true. It's definitely not true. So don't even bother wasting and asking, hey, does this work or not? And all of that. No, it's not. There might even, I've also seen some videos where they have some slick backstory about two college engineering students who were sued by the oil companies because their device saved fuel and all of that, and the oil companies want to keep it buried. That's also not true, and it's a 100% scam. Fuel saving device? Definitely not. There's only one place this belongs to, and it's not your engine.
That's our feature on Autopedia this week. Taking care of your ride has been made easier. And that's Autofocus this week. We hope you have found this edition of your automobile electronic magazine informative as well as entertaining. You can also check us out on our Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram accounts. On behalf of my dad, Butch Gamboa, this has been your host, Ray Louis Gamboa. Please stay safe and healthy.